Hello friends, so today we are going to discuss the problem D from Code Forces Round 665, problem name Maximum Distributed Tree. So you are given a tree consisting of n nodes, and you should know that you have to label the n minus 1 edges. So because it's a tree, it has n nodes, and so it must be having n minus 1 edges, and you have to label those n minus 1 edges in such a way that it satisfies these three conditions. Each integer must be greater than 0. Okay. Then the product of all the n minus 1 numbers, like which we label on these n minus 1 edges, should be equal to k. Okay. The third property is the number of 1s among all the n minus 1 integers should be minimum possible. Okay. Now, f of u to v is the sum of all the numbers in the simple path from u to v. So if there's a simple path connecting, because in tree there's only one simple path connecting every u to v node. So for every simple path, you have to do the sum of the numbers on the path, because we have labeled some numbers on the edges. And then you have to find out this for every two pair of u and v. This means that for every u and v, pair of u and v, you have to find out actually the sum of the paths. And this is called a distribution index of the tree. You have to maximize this distribution index, and you have to, because it can be very large, so you have to modulate to 10 to the power 9 plus 7. And this is also one good constraint in this question, which makes it easy, which is k can be very large. So the result of it is the prime factorization of k is given instead. So not actually k is given, but the prime factorization of k. Okay. So as you can see in the like input, because the first is there are four nodes, so there are n minus one edges, and then there are a prime factor of size like which is k. So k is written in the form of prime factors. There are two prime factors of k, which is 2 and 2. So the number of k is actually 4, so it is written in the form of prime factors, which is 2 and 2. So I hope you understand the question first now. So let's try to draw some tree to understand it more clearly. Let's assume that I have some tree. Okay, now I'll try to label it. Let's assume that this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And 6. Okay, now the basic intuition in such type of question is, because actually we have to see that for every path, so for 1 to 2 this is the path, for 1 to 3 this is the path, for 1 to 4 this is the path, so we have to label these indices or like these edges now, and the multiplication of them should be equal to k. Now actually, because k is written in the form of prime factors, which is like 2 and 2, you can understand this logic from the example also, because in the first example the prime factors are 2 and 2, so you have written down 2 and 2 and then written 1 somewhere. And also, as you can see in the second example, the prime factors are 3 and 2, so you have written 3 and 2 and then 1. So actually what this means that you can write down the prime factors and then 1, because the multiplication of all the numbers on the edges should be equal to k, and k is written in the form of prime factors, so you cannot divide it more further. And thus you can write them in the form of this, which is 2 and 2 and like the rest of the numbers which are not remaining. So because the prime factors are less in these cases, you can compensate this with adding 1. Okay, so like this is, you can compensate with this. Okay, so now let's assume that for this case also we have some prime factors, which is like 2. I don't know how to place these prime factors, but let's assume that you have like these 2 2 2. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 5 edges and we have some 2 numbers. Okay, so what you can do, because k is smaller, you can compensate it with some 1s. Like you can add 1, because of that, the when we place these numbers, the total multiplication would be equal to k. Okay, now you understand this point now. So what the second point is, because for every path, some edge is counted some number of times. That's the whole like the main crux of this question is, as you can see, when you go from 1 to 2, this edge is counted. When you go from 1 to 3, this edge is counted. 1 to 4, this edge is counted. So as you can see, this edge is counted in a number of simple paths. So if you can easily count out how many simple paths this edge will counted out, then we can easily see that how many paths will be there in which this edge will be taken. And when we do a total sum of the total sum for every path, so like this is the sum for first path, second path, third path. Now this path will consist of the sum of the edges. some of the edges. So if we find out the how many times each edge occur in every like every part, then we can see that okay, this edge occurs x1 times, this edge occurs x2 times. So it's just that we will take the label on this edge, multiply with x1, label on this x, multiply with x2, label on this edge, multiply with x3, and so on. So if we can easily find out what is x1, x2. Okay, now if my like cases find out x1, x2. X1, x2 means how many times this edge is used. So for every node on this side of this edge to every node on the that side of this edge, we will connect. What this means? For like if like there are one node here, and how many nodes are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So for every node on the left side of this edge, connects every node to the right side of this edge. So what we will do? We will connect them. Okay, so that's how we can see. If we can somehow find out how many nodes are there on the right side of the edge and same on the left side of the edge, we can multiply them and find out how many paths will be there. Same as you can see, if for this there are three nodes here and like three nodes here, so 3 into 3, it is 9. So in 9 simple paths, this edge will come. Okay, so this we will do some recursive function. I will tell you in the code. So what we can do here is I will also tell you with this example. So what you can do here is you can start your DFS from this point. You will iterate over all his children, and then you will count out, recursively count out how many nodes are there. So like you can check how many nodes are there, like you can recursively call a function which will tell us how many nodes are there above. If we find out how many children are there, for the children, for this there is a children of this node, so how many nodes are there in the total number of nodes including its children. If we know this number, and we know that the total number of nodes is n minus 1, so we can find out that okay, this number of nodes is, let's assume x, so this nodes is like x my like n minus 1 minus x, and so on. So that's how we can, because the actually the number of nodes is n, and this number of nodes is x, so you can find out that this is n minus x. Okay, so recursively I'll tell you how you can like call this function, and this function will tell us how many nodes are there on the right side, and then left side is just n minus x, and you can find out these how many times these values used. Now there are two cases to see. The first case is the key, the number of factors is less than n minus 1. Because there are n minus 1 edges, we know the frequency of how many times every edge will come. Okay, now if k, the number of factors which are given to us, is less than the number of so let's assume that it is less than the number of edges, then we will add some buffer ones so that it will become equal to the number of edges, and then we will multiply, because we want to maximize our like distribution index. What we'll do, we will multiply the maximum number, the maximum prime factor, with the maximum occurrence of, like if this edge occurred 2 times, this edge occurred 4 times, this edge occurred 100 times. So we will multiply the 100 time in edge with the maximum number prime factor, because that will increment the total with more. So that's what I've done. We will sort this out, and we will sort the frequency of these edges also, and we will multiply them one by one. But there can also be one case in which the number of prime factors can exceed the number of edges. So let's assume that there are a number which has prime factor like 2, 3, 5, 8, or like 5, and then again 2, 5, 3, and 4. So there are like, or like it's not 4, it's like 7. Then it's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There are 7 prime factors of a number which is k, and there are only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 5 edges. So how can we like put all these like prime factors on these edges? So it's better to multiply some of the prime factors, because we want eventually that the multiplication of all these numbers on these edges should be equal to k. So if you multiply these numbers and make it a larger number, we can use that larger number on an edge which has the maximum frequency. So what you will do, we want that the total size of this array should be equal to n minus 1, because we will multiply these n minus 1 edges with this n minus 1 prime factors. So what we will do, we will multiply the largest some largest numbers and make it equal to one number, such that this number and this one number will equal to n minus 1, such that now we are actually resizing our array, taking the largest number and multiplying them such that they will multiply and become a larger number, and then the new array will again have the size of n minus 1, and then we multiply this n minus 1 with these n minus 1 edges, and then the answer will come. I hope you understand the logic part now. Let's move on to the code part to make it more clear. So first, because there are test cases, this is the solve function. Take the input of n is global. N is global defined. Yeah, this is addition to matrix. This is the value. Value stores actually how many. This you can also store the frequency. This can be named as frequency also. Frequency means how many. What is the frequency of every edge? Okay, value actually that means. So we will clear R for every t or every test case. We will clear R value. Take the input of n at an addition to matrix. I make this addition to matrix. I have made this zero index because it is given in one index. I have like minus 1 with u and v and make it 0 index. Then I will use the DFA function which will store the frequency of every edge. So that's what I've told. What we can do, we will doing a DFS. So what we can do, we can start from 0 and we will store the parent of this, because for the first node there is no parent, so we will define it with minus 1. Then we will iterate over all the children. We will make our answer. Answer means how many nodes. Because see, answer will tell us, because we are talking about the nodes now. So this node is also counted as one. So like for this node, I have to talk about this edge now. So, but we also iterate over nodes only. We'll iterate over nodes only, but we will count or find out the total for edges. So we will, let's assume that start from this point. We will count this as one node and then iterate over all the children and then see what is the total number of edges on its children. I will tell you. So we will increment answer equal to 1. 1 means that we have counted this particular node on which we are, and then we will iterate over its children and send that its children is not the parent itself, and then how many next DFS means how many nodes are there on the children, how many total nodes are there on the children, and then val means like the frequency of every edge is pushed back like next into like this n minus next, which I've told you, which is actually finding out how many frequency of every edge, and then we will add this frequency of children into this answer, because this parent is also included in the children now for the next iteration, and then we'll return this answer. This is a different function. You can write on the paper to make it more clear also. And then we have find out all the frequency of all the edges. Then we will sort them out from largest to smallest. Then they will take the input of all the factors, and we will check that if the number of factors is less than n minus 1, then we will also add some buffer ones. Then we will sort these factors. Then answer is initialized to 0 because there is 0 sum for all the simple paths. And then there are two conditions. The first condition is because we have added these buffer values, the factor size or the number of factors is equal to n minus 1, in which they are actually equal, and when they are equal, we will iterate over all the factors from 0 to n minus 1, all the edges. And answer is, we have written down this function which is add and multiply because we have to do modulus. Then it is simple to make these three functions, which is very simple, and we don't have to take care about the moduluses. It is just make this function of mod, add and multiply, and it will take care of the modulus. So because you have to add in the answer the multiplication of factor of I into value of I, these are the greatest number, the greatest factor into the greatest frequency of every edge, and for every ith we will do the same, and we will store this in this answer. Else what will happen, the second case can be there are some buffer values and we have to multiply all those buffer values into one value. So because there are these z buffer values, because there is a total factorial size which is like a very large number, and there are n minus 1 numbers, we have to make our array equal to n minus 1, and then the original factorial size is very large. So factorial size minus n minus 1 will give us how many buffer or extra values are there. So we will, if I will iterate over all the factorial values, if I is less than z, which means that we are in the buffer value region, then we will multiply them, we will multiply actually the factorial I into I plus 1, which means that if that we have like we have numbers such that 5 5 3 and 2, and we have only two numbers in the factorial, or in the actually prime factors. These are prime factors and these are the number of edges, frequency of edges. Then we just want two numbers in the prime factors. So what we'll do, we will multiply this number and this number, which is equal, then we will make it equal to 25, 3 and 2. And then we will multiply this 25 into 3, will become 125 and 2. And then this size will become equal to the frequency. The frequency or the n minus 1, the frequency of edges. And then we can multiply this with this and this with this. So what we can do, we will multiply this I and I plus 1. Multiply I and I plus 1 till we come to this point. And that's what we are doing. We are actually multiplying, when it is less than z, we are multiplying I. We are storing actually I plus 1 in the factorial of I plus 1, factor I plus 1. We are storing I and I plus 1. And when we come to the original point, what we will do? We will multiply the factorial ith point on which we are and val value. But because we are ahead in the iteration, we are multiplying, we are actually using this x equal to 0 because we are multiplying the first value of this with the new value of this and so on. So you can write down on the paper to make it more clear if you have still any doubts. That's the code and then you output the answer. If you still have any doubts, a single doubt, please mention it in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel. I'll see you in the next one. Keep coding. Bye.